Man, listen, LeBron James is not the smartest basketball player ever. I don't care what Draymond Green keep dick riding this man for. LeBron James is not the smartest basketball player ever. He's not. His IQ is not the smartest. And let me tell you why. Go watch Kobe Bryant with Charles Barkley in the crew when they criticized Kobe for not taking enough shots in that Game 7 loss to the Phoenix Suns in the first round. Take a look what Kobe said. Kobe Bryant said this. Kobe is probably the smartest basketball player in basketball history. The smartest. And why he the smartest? Because he beat three top 75 players and four Hall of Famers on one team in 2010 with no top 75 player. Just him as the only lone top 75 player. But that's besides the point. That just adds to my point. My point is this. Charles and the media think they were so smart by saying, well, Kobe had 24 points that game. He was 18 of 16, 56 from the field. Kobe Bryant noticed in that series against the Phoenix Suns like to score. So him scoring 50 points against the Phoenix Suns, which he did twice that season, once in game six and then once in the regular season. They lost both times. He's saying scoring against them doesn't do anything to them. They want you to score. So what I need to do, we need to play defense. I need to get other players involved. Because once they get involved offensively, they're going to play the energy on the defense, they're going to help them offensively and defensively. And you got to demoralize Phoenix by stopping them from scoring. Because they want to score anyway. The Jim Jackson said this. He fouled a guy from a wide open breakaway layup. Mike D'Antoni said, why you foul him? Let him make the layup. We want to keep on running. I'll make backs or not. If a miss or a make, we want to keep running. Don't foul him. You stopping the time. You stopping the pace. So that tells you, Mike D'Antoni and Kobe. We have to demoralize. I can score 20 points in the quarter against them. It's not going to do anything to them because they want to score anyway. So you got to stop them defensively. So Charles Barkley trying to make it like you just see him score 50 points and lost. So he come back game seven trying to get his teammates involved. Why having a pretty good, a damn good game, 24 points? He averaged 24 for his career, 24 in the game. Anyways, and when they was asking him, LeBron James was getting ready to make it to the finals that year, and the halftime party, he said, see, LeBron James, he's doing a good job. He's the guy that he's dictating pace. He could control the pace of the game, which is great. And asked him, Kenny Smith asked Kobe, against Detroit, a defensive team like Detroit, would you try to impose your will on scoring, or would you try to defend? Would you try to score more against them, or would you try to lock them down? What would demoralize them? He said, "What Detroit? They're a different team because they can't score a lot. So what I would do, I'll impose my will on trying to score, because if I score 20 points in the quarter against them, it's very likely that they can keep up with the scoring. So I would impose my will by scoring. The greatest shit ever, brilliant. Some of the most brilliant shit ever." Michael, LeBron James, and like I always tell y'all about LeBron James, he's a ball-dominated guy. Being a ball-dominated guy is the reason why they lost to Orlando Magic. Nobody else could get involved and score and not score, but create offense for themselves or create offense for others. See, LeBron James would be one of the greatest players ever, in my opinion, if he would have switched his role and play out the post. If he was a great post player, he can play out the post. They're going to double team. If they don't double team, you go one-on-one and kill whoever on you. You're going to kill. Play LeBron James one-on-one post. He's going to kill you. Even though he didn't have a great post-up game, you're still going to demand a double team. You kick it out, your defense is going to collapse. You pass it, you get the hockey assist. Instead of trying to get the play on the perimeter and get the full assist by passing to open shooters and making do spot-up shooters, it's not very smart. Making Chris Bosh and Kevin Love a spot-up shooter is not very smart. That's not their game. He didn't. If he was a, if Matt Johnson had those type of play, Matt Johnson's a smart player. If Matt Johnson had those type of talent, he would have 16, 17, 18 assists a night. What 16, 17, 18 point? But they'd been winning at a high clip. They had one more championship. 4 out of 10, he had the opportunity to pass Michael Jordan. What if LeBron went eight championships out of 10? What if LeBron went 9? What if LeBron went all 10? What if LeBron went 6, 5 out of them 10 tries? He's not as smart because he thought he can outscore Golden State. What he should have did and told his team is we got to demoralize Golden State, not trying to score point for point for them. I'm going to take the challenge of guarding Kevin Durant, and I'm going to score 25 to 27, 26, 24 points a night. I'm going to let Kyrie Irving, Kevin Love, J.R. Smith carry the offense a little more. Not just carry the load. I'm going to lean on Kyrie's scoring ability, Kevin Love in the post. We're going to slow the game down. I'm going to take Kevin Durant out of 35 points a night. Bring him down to, 29 or 30 or 28. Have him shoot high volume, not 55% from the field. That would have been more smarter. So he's not smart. Let's get that out the way. He's actually only smart in what works do for him. So that's the thing when J-Ron, he just want to big up the guy because he's making a lot of money with LeBron James. That's it. And I hope I broke that down for you. And I hope y'all can like, subscribe, and tell me and drop comment below and tell me what y'all think. That's what I had to say about that. Anyway, y'all like, subscribe, share my perspective, share this video, and keep on sharing and liking it so I can make more content for you guys. Thank y'all.